G'day and welcome to this instructional video on the difference between England and New Zealand. I'm from this one. Over in England, they've got the Royals. Well, here in New Zealand, we've just got Royals. And we'll never be royals. Here in New Zealand, we really love our sport. And when we're at like the stadium, you know, we sit down quietly and kind of watch the game and stay focused. We're over in England, for some reason, they think they're just at like an American Idol audition and they just sing like the whole time. England, England, England. Very badly and out of tune. Coming for to carry me off. So the biggest difference between England and New Zealand is probably the accents. Here in New Zealand, throughout the whole country, our accent pretty much stays the same. Like we don't have different kind of dialects. It's all just like what I'm doing now with my teeth and lips and mouth. Where over in England, it kind of changes between town to town, innit? They've got all these different, if you go up the road, it sounds a little bit different. I'll give you an example of that if I could do the different ones, but the only one I can really do is like this kind of, this London bricklayer, innit? Oh, hello, I'm the queen. Hello, I'm the queen, hello. All right, and I'm a queen, ain't I? Yeah, sweet bruv. In England, they have an award-winning TV show called Coronation Street. Here in New Zealand, we have a hospital ward drama called Shortland Street. I don't think it's won any awards, but it's good.
Please tell me that is not your penis.
For wow, we say far out, they say blimey. For oh no, we say bugger, they say bollocks. For mistake, we say balls up, they say cock up. In England, they have like the whole of Europe as like a close holiday destination, where here in New Zealand, our nearest holiday destination country is Australia. In England, you're kind of weirdly squashed, like between like Wales and Scotland, and like Ireland's over there, and then you got Europe trying to push on you. We're here in New Zealand, we're kind of just floating around on our own in the Pacific Ocean. It's kind of like we're in international waters, so we just do what we want. Like, wear ridiculously short shorts. In England, you guys have got like that big frozen wall, that big wall to defend your borders. We're here in New Zealand, we've got Mordor. Throughout England, you have like really good public transport, especially in your cities. We're here in New Zealand, we don't. So if you could like just send over a couple of tubes, that'd be real cool. Cheers. England has castles. We're here in New Zealand, we've got mean as marais. Here in New Zealand, we call this a gumboot. And if you throw it, it's a proper sport called gumboot throwing. Where over in England, they call this a Wellington or like a welly. And when they throw it, they call it welly winging, which just sounds really disgusting. Oh, if this was like a barbecue of countries, then, and New Zealand was the host, then like Australia, that'd be like our stepbrother at the party. Like you kind of get along and you know each other. And they're kind of funny 2% of the time, but that's about as far as it goes. Where England would be like that weird uncle. He probably should have left like 200 years ago, but he's still here kind of shoving his elbows about. He did a few things, bought a few good things, did some kind of weird stuff. But, you know, we're good now. You could probably leave. But they're just kind of just standing up the corner, just like peering, just watching what's going on. Now and then they like pop out and do a little wave, and then they're just... But they're always there, just what, like we're okay now, unless you've got like heaps of sausages for the barbecue. But I think grandma's actually got all the sausages, so grandma's the queen. She's sausages is money. So it was a lovely wedding though. Congratulations, Will and Harry, Kate, Michelle. That was the difference between England and New Zealand. And now that we're done, I'm just gonna pop off and get myself a cup of tea, yeah? Unless this was an English building site, then I'd be, oh, I'm just gonna go get my 17th cup of tea of the morning. They'd they slam back the tea on those buildings. So, hey, dear England builders, cut back on the tea, get heaps more done. A lot more time for you guys to head out back and wang some wellies. This, wang some.